Hi. So I'm gonna be reacting to this coming out video. I think her channel would be Mega Wago something. I just found her 'cause I was just looking up coming out videos and hearing people's stories, and I like listening to them, and sometimes they're very emotional. So yeah. So this is her video of coming out, and I'll be reacting to her story. Yeah.
My parents did not, and that is that I am bisexual. And I had just come out to them not even 20 minutes ago. Just feels like a ton of weight is lifted off of me. You know, they still don't understand what that means. And I understand that as well.
I get it.
But I'm glad to be told that they're still gonna love me and care about me, and I should try to find myself a little more within what I do. When I had a crush on this girl, and I felt really disgusting, I felt really terrible with myself. I was not called nice things by other people. A lot of people hated me because I scared them, and I didn't mean to. I've been keeping this in for a really, really long time. Saying that my family doesn't fully understand it yet. I can be who I want to be, which is myself.
Yeah. I mean, I get that. I know the feeling so much. I mean, trust me, like, well, I do know that feeling. Like, people, like, you know, LGBT, like, we're like a family. And I'm bi myself. And I get it. Like, the feeling of, like, people knowing you and seeing the real you, expressing yourself, and finally being able to be you and see yourself. It's just, like, it's refreshing. It's, like, a weight has lifted off your shoulders. It's, like, a relief of, like, stress. And it just feels really good, and I get that. I do get that. Don't cry. I get it.
I look like a troll.
No.
It is March right now. And,
no matter how you look, you're beautiful, okay?
Whenever I feel insanely upset, I write.
By the way, I think you're cute. I'm just saying, like, you're beautiful no matter what. And it's really brave and confident, you know, that you are being open and, you know, these videos saying, you know, your story, and that shows true bravery. And, you know, confidence in yourself and who you are. And I remember, like, when I made my video, I remember that. And how crazy it was. And how emotional it felt for me. So I get the feeling, you know, coming out is a very scary and terrifying process to go through, because you can go either way, and people accept you or not, especially your family.
one of my best friends has given me. Her name is Emily. She's really sweet. And she understands who I am and why I am the way that I am. She gave me this so I could write in it.
Aww.
And I could write out my frustrations.
Yeah.
And of March last year, this is one of my last entries. I haven't really written in here. It's been over a year. It's March 12th right now, so it's a little over a year from when I have written in here. So this entry, this is actually the second to last entry. This is written March 2nd of 2015. It says, when you start thinking about something in particular, your brain just can't seem to stop thinking about it. My brain's been doing this for about 8 to 9 months. I think about it every day. I just can't stop. It seems like the more I ponder over it, the more I want it to actually happen. I wanted to move so bad. I'm not happy here. I want a new start. I want to start fresh, somewhere new, like a boarding school or just running away. I'm tired of feeling so shitty all the time. I just know that soon I won't be able to take it anymore. I just want this year to end. I want a decision to be made and my dreams to come into play. I want to be myself. That's all I want. For years, I was not able to be myself. I was not able to be so content with my sexuality because people nowadays only understand gay and straight. They don't understand anything else.
Yeah.
Because gay was a hard pill to swallow. Now there's other terms as transsexual, polysexual, bisexual, there's so much. Why does everything have to be labeled? Why can't I just love who I want to love? It's going to be really tough to be who I am because I'm not used to it. And if I can do it, then anybody else can. I used to not think that. Anytime I would see somebody do it on YouTube or like just anybody tell me that they came up to their parents, I'm like, that will never be me.
Yeah, right, I know.
I know it is. I don't know how to react to it. I just want to eat ice cream now and watch movies because it's the only thing that makes me feel better.
Yeah.
Don't be afraid to be who you
want. Cream.
If you wait too long, it will track forever.
Yeah. Now I want some ice cream now. But that video was I almost cried. A little bit, but I was really emotional. Like, oh my god. Props to her for making this video. People that make coming out stories, like these videos, that they put this story out there for everyone to listen, to see, and hear, you know. People say, oh, you shouldn't do that. But in a way, I think it does inspire people. Because even though most stories are not that happy like others are, some are very sad or depressing. But when they tell the story, they show that how strong they are. And then, even though I've been through that, I'm still alive. Some people, they kill themselves. And it's so sad to see that. That they should be alive to see the world change. Even though it took like forever, you know? Because LGBT has a long history of fighting for their rights to love whoever they want to love. And, like, wow. I, for one, am proud of being bi. And, yeah. Anyway, hope I didn't do... Oh, sorry. I can't talk right now. Please give the video a thumbs up if you liked it. This reaction video, whatever, coming out for reaction. subscribe to my channel for more videos, and if you like to, please hit the notification bell to let you know whenever I upload a new video, alright? So,